Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the INDATA Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. Today, we're going to do something a little bit different with our tech tip. I'm going to show you something that's not really an assistive technology, but I think it has some assistive technology applications. You'll see here on the table in front of me is a product from WowWee that costs about $70 or $80 called MIP, M-I-P, and he's a little robot. And I get excited about robots, so I was happy to find this little guy, and I wanted to show you some things about him that I think are interesting. On the screen behind me, you'll see that I have my iPhone screen projected so you can see what's happening here in my hand. I've just got a regular iPhone that's connected to him via Bluetooth, and he's running on some AAA batteries there. And the first feature he has is a drive feature. So if I select this drive feature, you're going to see that I have the ability to drive this little guy around. And I can move him forward, and I can move him backward, and I can also spin him around so that he can... I can drive him around my bedroom, I can drive him around the office, I can annoy my coworkers, which I do sometimes with this little guy. And it's just a cool way to have a handheld control for this little robot. So that's the basic features, and that's what most folks are going to do with him. However, he's got another thing called Dance, which is kind of cool. If I go into the menus here and select Dance, and I choose a song, it's going to look at my iTunes library, and I'm just going to pick a Jackson 5 song here and tell it play, and he's going to dance to the music. So that's kind of a fun way to enjoy music and to have the robot interact with somebody who might have autism or that kind of a disability. But here's the thing that I find most interesting about him. In fact, let me turn him back around here a little bit so he's a little easier to see. In the settings is a thing called cans. And what it says is feed different canisters and see how its mood changes and does quirky routines. And when I started playing with this guy, I realized that he has, and you can see on the screen, a can of happy, a can of guilty, a can of grumpy, a can of angry, and a can of sad, and there are some others here. So if I take this can of happy and feed it to him, he's gonna act happy, which I think is interesting. And we'll watch him here. And he said, oh yeah, and spun around and acted happy. Or if I say grumpy, give him a can of grumpy, he'll act a little bit grumpy. He kind of growls and charges forward a little bit. He fell off the table. He's okay, he'll survive. He's fairly durable, so I'm not too worried about that. There's another can here that I think is interesting. I can tell him a can of sleepy. And we'll see what he does. So he's snoring. And he falls over and he falls asleep. So this isn't really an assistive technology thing per se, but I think when we're talking about people who have issues with understanding moods and behaviors and emotions, this is a nice tool or a nice toy to be able to kind of practice some of those and get a better handle on what does happy look like and what does sad look like. So an interesting thing, we're playing around with robotics here a lot and trying to figure out how they might be used in a social context. And we got a little bit excited about this MIP robot because he's a pretty cool little guy that does all kinds of fun stuff. So that's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the INDATAProject at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.